Hey guys, welcome to day three of this round of workouts. Okay, so let's get started. Exercise one is Bulgarian split squat on the ball. Okay, now members doing this one might need a little bit of assistance from me to get on here the first time you've never used a stability ball. Okay, basically, you're gonna put one foot on the ball, okay? Starting off like this, nice and close, okay? And then from there, they're going to step themselves out, okay? Now the idea here is that they step themselves out so that when they come into a lunge, the front foot or the front leg is going to come to 90 degree angle, and we're not going to come forward. Okay, so we want to make sure we're pushing our way back. Okay, and then from here, I'm losing my balance. Sorry, too much talking. Okay, so placing one foot on, stepping yourself out. Okay, helping your members if they need it, or getting you two in front of the wall if they need to. And then you come down. Trying to go down. You can roll the ball in slightly with your foot, okay, as they come down. So that way you can keep the pressure on your front. Okay? That's exercise one. Exercise two, we have a partner assisted sit up with toss. Okay, so you're going to use the 5 pound, sand bag for this one, okay? Basically, you're going to have partners facing each other. Don't get them to crisscross their legs or anything like that. Just get them to face each other, okay? Now, if you have anybody that's, you know, a few people that are really strong and hardcore in the class, you can try to use the heavier 20 pound sand bag for this, okay? But I suggest you start off with this, okay? So you're gonna come down, holding this nice and close to the chest, come up into a sit up and toss it to the front. Okay, then you're both gonna come down, and then your partner's gonna toss you, the sand bag, you're gonna catch, and you're gonna hold strong, okay? Exercise two, staggered push up. Sorry, it's exercise three, staggered push up. Okay, so basically staggered push-up, one hand is doing a close grip push-up, like a tricep push-up, while the other hand is doing a regular push-up, okay, with the elbow coming up to the side, okay? And you're basically going to do that, okay, for halfway, okay, and then you're going to switch, okay? So one elbow is gliding along the side of my body, and the other one is coming up to the side of the tricep push-up, okay? And you can do this on your knees as well, all right? Then next up, we have a partner-assisted run, which you guys are quite familiar with. So one person has the band around their hip bone while the other one is holding, okay? Now, let this go on for halfway, and then they can switch, okay? Then we have, so actually for that one, I want you to really, really try to hold your partner back, okay? Instead of letting them run forward, just really try to get our partners to really work on their high eight movement, working on the squat, with some resistance, okay? So you're holding the back, okay? Nice firm stance, while the other person is trying to, you know, really, really sprint on the spot and move forward, but they really can't, okay? Okay, next up, last one in this round, we have sandbag wood chop, okay? So, okay, so for this, guys, actually, I think we're gonna have to switch this up because we originally thought these sandbags were a little bit different. So I'm gonna see if this works actually right now, okay? So that is keeping it up on top of your shoulder, okay? Inhale and exhale down, okay? So inhale, bringing it up on top of your shoulder and exhale down, okay? Inhale up and exhale down. Inhale up and exhale down, okay? You wanna grab onto the leg as well so that way you protect the shoulder as you come up, okay? And then dropping it down with a nice flat spot. Okay, if you have members that simply cannot hold a 20 pound, you can get them to go back to doing it with the band until they can build up some strength to be able to do it, okay? So you're coming down, all right? And then you're coming up, extending that band, okay? Coming down and extend, okay? Switching sides halfway. All right, and then set two. We have sandbag alternating lateral squat. So back to a little bit of legs. We're gonna either use a 30 pound or 20 pound for this. You guys can gauge how your class is doing. If you know this week you find most people are not like, oh, you know, that was really tough, increase it to 30 pound, okay? So see what your members need and want, okay? So starting off with a nice, you know, with a nice good posture, we're gonna lunge up to the side, going as deep as possible, trying to make contact with the bag on the floor. And the outside foot is staying flat on the ground. Basically feeling a stretch in the leg as you're coming down. Again, my back is now rounding over as I lunge, okay? So now exhale, come back to center. Down to one side. Okay, so we're alternating, keeping good posture, pulling our navel into our spine as we come out of the lunge, okay? That's exercise one. Exercise two, decline stability while push-up. So we're going to show you a couple of options here, okay? So beginner option, you're going to place basically the majority of the bottom of the leg from the knee down on the ball, okay? So you have quite a bit of stability there, okay? And then from there, okay, you're going to have your arms a little bit wider than shoulder width, and you're going to dip down, okay? Be keeping the navel tucked into the spine. So this position is going to provide quite a bit of stability for the person, okay? If you're just doing knee push-ups, okay? And then for people a little bit more advanced, you'll be able to take more of the leg off of the ball, and then from there, come down to a push-up, okay? Now, if people are not ready to get the stability ball, by all means, get to just do a regular push-up until they build up to this, okay? Next up, we have sandbag deadlifts. Okay? So, again, I suggest using 30 pounds for this, okay? So, beginning with nice wide legs. Okay, we're doing wide-legged. And here goes the ball again. Okay, deadlift. So, you're going to come down, dropping the bag, and come up. Okay? Down. And up, okay? For those people that are ready for a bit more range of motion, just get them to hold a bit of the bag here, okay? That way it's, actually, if we hold the side, it's much better for this, okay? So hold the sides of the bag, and then come up. Okay, that way you can get a little bit more range of motion, holding the sides, getting deeper into the movement, okay? So sides versus front, all right? Then we have partner-assisted run. Oh. Yeah, doing partner-assisted run once again, okay? Just because it's a great exercise, most people really like it. And partner roll back to standing, okay? Now for the second run, let's try to get members to actually run forward, okay? So let's give them a little bit of leeway to move forward versus the first one where I asked you to really hold them in place, okay? So you're resisting them, but also letting them run, okay? And then partner roll back to standing. So for this one, I want you to imagine that you have a partner. I have a partner, okay? My partner is standing right in front of me, okay? I'm gonna be on my mat, I'm gonna perform a roll up to standing, and they're gonna assist me to come up with their hands, okay? So they need to be in a nice, stable stance to be able to help me come up, okay? So I'm just gonna go like this, roll back, okay? And my partner grabs my hands and helps me also come down properly, because a lot of people here can't really come down, okay? So it helps me come down properly, and then I come back to it, okay? So grab and repeat, okay? So the person standing needs to be in a nice firm stance, nice and low, so that if the person can't come up on their own, they can really grab onto their hands and help them stand. Okay? And that's it, guys. Enjoy day three. Let me know if there's any questions. See you later. Bye.